Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, we are from group 3. We'll present our materials about biological control of Prunella psilostela on cabbage plant. Before we start our presentation, let me introduce our group member. Mamat Irsyad with student number 80, Arifan Hanani with student number 81, Nindi Khatun Salma with student number 83. The first topic is classification of Prunella psilostela. Prunella psilostela is a major pest of cabbage. When population number are high, the larva eat all the leaf and leave only the bones of the leaf, causing severe damage. The classification of Prunella psilostela according to Mires et al. On 2015, namely kingdom from Animalia, phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, ordo Lepidoptera, family Prutellidae, genus Prunella, and species is Prunella psilostela L. This pest caused 20-30% damage to cabbage plants. Even so that the product of this plant can no longer be sold. This type of pest occupies a position as the main pest. Life cycle of Prunella psilostela. First egg, the eggs are oval in color and yellow in color. The female moth lay eggs singly or in small groups around the leaf plates on the surface and the underside of the cabbage. Second larva, the body is green or pale yellow with clear body segments and has fine hairs. Larvae have five pairs of prolex. This larva consists of four instar. Third, imago. The male Prunella psilostela at rest has four wings covering the body and it looks like a white parallelogram like a diamond. This caused the pest to be known as the diamondback moth.
Symptom of attack Prunella psilostela. The first instar larvae feed on cabbage leaf by making holes in the underside of the leaf. Second, instar larvae emerge from transparent burrow and feed on leaf tissue on the underside of leaf. The growth of infected cabbage plants is hampered because the number of stomata on the leaf is limited. Next. Pest control Prunella psilostela. Number one is using plants that have the prospect of being used as vegetable pesticide. Number two, using entomopathogenic fungi such as Viverra bassiana. Number three, using bacteria which are also natural enemies of Prunella psilostela, namely Bacillus thuringiensis. Number four, the release of natural enemies like Trichogramma. Next, type of plant that have the prospect of being used as vegetable pesticide include Kenaker leaves, Pertusan leaf, and Lagetan leaf. Kenaker leaf extract contain flavonoids, glycoside, and quercetin. Flavonoid compounds are known to be able to induce the inhibition of DNA activity. Rahayu et al. 2012. Pertusan leaf extract has almost the same content as Kenaker leaf. Pertusan leaf contains important compound or metabolite such as saponins, flavonoids, polyphenol, and essential oil. Kinase 2013. Next.
Application of Viverria basiana in the form of conidia can infect insect through the cuticular digestive system, mold, and segment found on the insect's body. The fungi Viverria basiana in the insect's body produce a toxin called viverriacin, which damages the structure of cell membrane so that the insect dies. The fungi Viverria basiana will continue its silical growth in the subtropic phases. After the host insect dies, Viverria basiana will issue an antibiotic, namely oosporin, which suppress the bacterial population in the host insect's stomach. Next. Bacteria that are also natural enemies of Plutella psilostela are Bacillus thuringiensis. Berliner wheat is a pathogenic to all Plutella psilostela larval instar and can be used to control Plutella psilostela in the field. Bacillus thuringiensis cause the larval's body to be black, mushy, and foul smelling due to paralysis in the digestive tract. Next. The release of natural enemies such as a trichogramma can control Plutella pest population. Eggs of Plutella psilostela parasitized by trichogramma have a characteristic, namely black color, while healthy eggs are greenish yellow. The black color on the eggs of the parasitized host begins to appear 4 until 5 days after the parasitoid eggs are laid. Next. Okay, thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.